Hello, we're here today to talk to Todd, who represents Liquid Robotics from Sunnyvale, California. Welcome to Wellington and to New Zealand, Todd.
Thank you very, very much.
How's your trip? What have you been doing here?
Well, this morning was excellent. We had a good group of people that are interested in how robots might be able to help New Zealand off the coastline. We've started discussions with a couple of different groups here, talking about all different industries that are important to New Zealand's coast.
That would probably be fisheries too, would it?
Yeah, fisheries, meteorological data, even fiber optic cables, surveillance of marine protected areas, lots of different things.
And what is the machine that you're working with, the robot? What does it exactly do?
So we've created a wave-powered device. It's basically a robot that uses wave power to fuel it all around the world. So it doesn't require any additional fuel source to power it to go worldwide. So it can cover New Zealand. It could cover the Southern Sea. We're talking to somebody about Antarctic exploration for ice. It could do missions year-round, 24 hours a day.
And is there equipment on this robot that's sending out signals to a monitoring base or anything?
Yes. So there's a host of changeable sensors. So there's not just one sensor package. It can host everything from seismic data to tsunami warning information to meteorological data. So the sensors can change. We're more of a mobile data network, if that helps.
And how many of these robots are around the world?
We have hundreds deployed now. We've done over 300,000 nautical miles of the Earth. We actually have the world record for the most days traveled for an autonomous robot.
Wonderful.
Yeah, yeah.
And are there any close to New Zealand?
We have some in Australia that are right off the coast of Australia now. We've been deployed worldwide, and so everywhere from Japan to Korea to Malaysia now currently uses units as well.
They sound quite expensive. Are they something we can all afford?
Yes. So they are very, very expensive, but they do a job that typically, we just learned today that a ship in New Zealand may cost upwards of $10,000 to $30,000 a day in fuel costs, and our wave gliders don't cost anything for fuel, so that's one. And typically they're less than $1 million US, but the range is quite high, depending upon how many sensors are on them. So if there's only one sensor, it may cost a heck of a lot less.
And where was the technology developed? How did that happen?
It was developed off the coast of Hawaii for a guy by the name of Joe Rizzi, who wanted to listen to whale song. He wanted to actually listen to whales in his living room so that he could hear the whales. And then that kind of formed an idea in his head, which says, we could use this for a lot of scientific data. What other industries would be interested in something that's silent and that doesn't require any fuel?
And where is he now? Is he still part of the company?
He's on our board. He's an active member of the company. Joe had founded a number of different companies in the United States, and then has a research center that he works off of Juniper Networks that does research for various industries, and he's still actively involved in the company.
And when you make a wave glider robot, is that made in Sunnyvale, California?
Yes, it's made in Sunnyvale, California.
100%?
100%.
And what sort of components are part of it? Is it a big machine? Would we recognize it if we walked out the door?
I hope so. It's about the size of a surfboard. So it's got a two-part system. The lower part uses the wave motion. The top part uses solar, so it can actually communicate off of satellite or cellular phone. And they're very simple to deploy. So they're about the size of a typical surfboard. Maybe you'd call it a longboard, I think. Well, New Zealand has an enormous coastline and a lot of different areas around it that New Zealand tries to help, other islands that New Zealand tries to help that may need marine protected area research, or maybe algae blooms or acidity in the water, turbidity or sediment levels that change because of exploration or surveying. So there's a lot of different applications for New Zealand because New Zealand has it's an ocean-bound country, and it has a very unique opportunity to use these because they're easy to deploy. And robots work, as I'd said, all year long and don't need a vacation.
I imagine a lot of countries are making sure that their fish stocks are kept maintained and monitored. Do we lose a lot of fish around the world?
So on average, most countries worldwide will say there's any between a $10 billion and a $25 billion loss because of illegal fishing. So even though New Zealand has its own fishing area, the EEZ, which was just expanded in New Zealand, is at threat from multiple countries that may come down here and fish and not tell anybody about it. And so there's a big need there.
And we have a lot of forestry in New Zealand. Mm-hmm. Could you use this in forestry?
So transportation of the forestry goods probably out of the country happens on shipping companies. And shipping companies care an awful lot about their fuel. Every shipping company in the world could use these as a way to get weather information in front of the ship to save on fuel costs and to save on like maybe even a bad route. So the logging industry uses it inadvertently in a different way. But we could, I don't think we can transport logs on the wave glider just yet.
And what about the oil and gas? Because that's something that we are pushing at the moment.
Oil and gas, if there was an oil spill anywhere, we are able to detect oil spills from platforms themselves or if they're drilling. And the applications for oil and gas are pretty big. So they have a lot of research they do on the ocean, and we can help with about 95% of that exploration.
You may have heard that we have earthquakes in New Zealand, so tsunamis are very topical too.
Yes.
Could you use this machine for a tsunami?
We are currently using the device in multiple phases for tsunami detection and for preventative measures that you might be able to look at weather patterns or things that are changing to predict and add more value to your tsunami warning systems, including the existing DART system, which is used worldwide.
Do you think a country like New Zealand is moving towards robots more and more?
Yeah, I think so. I think because there's such a large swath of ocean that needs to be covered, you know, UAVs for the aerial and then something like a liquid robotics wave glider for the ocean just makes an awful lot of sense. You know, it's very difficult to deploy ships that cost upwards of tens of $20,000 a day because of fuel costs when you can put a robot out there that doesn't cost anything for fuel.
And you don't have to pay it, do you?
No, you don't have to pay the robot.
Or feed it.
Nor feed it.
Well, thank you, Todd. What else do you plan to do in New Zealand? Have you got other plans?
Yes, I need to go and find some things that I was instructed by my wife to bring back because I can't find them anywhere else but New Zealand.
Can you tell us one or two things?
Some of the things I'm not supposed to bring on an airplane, so we won't talk about those. But the other things, there's an incredible burn cream that New Zealand has that I've used, and I bought bottles of it last time I was here. And actually, believe it or not, there's a gel that you have here specifically, can't find anywhere for, canker sores, which is a New Zealand-based product, which is excellent.
Excellent. Good to hear that.
We love New Zealand.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.